Thank you very much. Pastor Hastings, we praise God for the privilege of being here on today and to share in this tremendous occasion, and to Brother Griffin, our worship and MC of the program, and to the leadership that is gathered here. We certainly want to thank Mr. Pierce and his staff and all those who gathered together to make it. I want to thank, first of all, today, Dr. Brewster. It's a mighty poor frog that doesn't squawk about his own pond. We in Georgia have the best leader of Boy Scouts at that time. No, I know in the AME Church, and maybe in some other churches too. And you are here largely in the country, largely because of his efforts. And we are planning to assist. So forget everything else that I say. We have a great leader, and I am endorsing and want the pastors, presiding elder, leadership of our churches to participate in the Boy Scout program. Not because Dr. Brewster said so, but because it is an outstanding program. So if you forget everything else that I say, when I'm only going to talk about an hour and a half, you will just remember that. Let me also express my gratitude to the elders and pastors who have come, to the leadership of the Sons of Allen, to those who have come from churches, and to these Boy Scouts who have come. I was pleasantly surprised. I have so many grandchildren and children that I didn't know that my grandson would be here representing his Cub Scout troop. Wait, I'll further embarrass him. Clayton, where are you? Stand up, son, let him see you. This is my Cub Scout in the Turner troop, and he was a flag bearer. And I want you to know he got it right. Professionals in scouting who have done such an outstanding job and who are entertaining us today. Let me just say quickly that I think it's important for the AME Church to be a vital part of the Boy Scout program, because we're in a losing battle right now for the futures of our young African-American men. We're not winning that battle. We don't have enough people in school. We have too many people that are incarcerated. We have too many people who are not fulfilling their obligation now. That I'm not depressed by those statistics, because we also have an outstanding group of people who are doing well. Yeah. But we do need to not let it pass by. I had a chance the other day to read the book that Bill Cosby and Dr. Boussant wrote concerning their response to in the African American community. The subtitle has to do with going from victim to victor. It has to do with come on, people. It's a challenge to us to quit complaining about what somebody did to us and do something for ourselves. Now, that's an in-house message, but I'm going to say it in the public today. Boy Scouting is one way in which we can have a fine job of encouraging our young men and giving them some things to do. I was very pleased to see, if I had a voice like Sean when I was his age, I would have been a bishop a lot earlier than I did. He has, not only does he not stand the voice, but he has the poise, and he and his brother and Anthony and others who came to share with us. You put people up in front of groups like this and tell them that they're somebody. Put them in a uniform. Tell them that you're proud of them. I'm telling you, it's important. That. Yes, I didn't get very far in Boy Scouts, but I got mainly to where I am by people in church encouraging me. Now, you can do it. The Sons of Allen are the feeder group. They are the ones where we take our Boy Scouts and move on forward. So, You model something for them. If you just see the kind of pride that we have in these folk today. We're looking for leadership. We need a new generation of leadership. It does not happen. It does not something that just kind of falls on you. When I was in the infantry school years ago, right down here in Fort Benning, they have people that have studied all their lives about how to get the credentials of leadership and tell you what, how to be responsible and how you use integrity and how people have to depend on you. So we're looking for leadership among the Boy Scouts. We're looking to teach people cooperation, that they are not superstars by themselves, that they must cooperate with the other folk in their families, that they can make a big difference. And then we need to teach boys how to serve. We don't have these blessings unto ourselves. We must share them. So when you have opportunity to even go to meetings like this, and when you earn badges, and when you are able to speak in public and you're able to carry the flag, and there are boys and girls who do not understand, and there are even some who make fun of you for doing it. But you need to remind them that we are doing this so that more of us can serve in the days which lie ahead and have the outreach. So we are looking to move from where we are to what we ought to be. For us adults, we need to carve out the space. For us adults, we need to encourage. We need to say, you are somebody. And that's the reason that I got to where I am today. Wherever I am today, I got here because somebody, in spite of whatever I was doing or not doing, said, we believe you can do it. Had little ladies come to me after church when I was a young preacher, and sometimes I had failed in the sermon. But Hitchcock, they don't know that in Texas, but every time I'm a preacher, we'll do what my professor preacher used to call have a black block punt. Someday you just get off the ground. So you, every now and then people would tell you you did well in spite of yourself. Outstanding young men who are here today in these uniforms are sometimes under pressure from their peers not to do things like that. The word they used when I was younger was hokey. I don't know what the word is now. But it wasn't cool. It wasn't that which they wanted to do. They talked them down. So that's like excellence in high school. Sometimes it's hard for an African-American person. It's all right for you to be the star halfback. But if you have a four-point average, sometimes you have to take a little guff from your friends. When you're an Eagle Scout, on your way to be an Eagle Scout, when you're in the scouting program, when you're dressed up and looking nice as you are, somebody will disagree with that and say that's not a part of what we're doing. We have got to encourage them. We have got to reward them, and we have got to send them away. So we're looking for you to be better servants. Leaders, cooperative, adventure, and to serve the community. Now the AMEs are going to do all we can to support the program here in Georgia. Everything that we can, and hope that it spreads across the church, because we have to make sure that there's a transition of development and leadership. In the Bible, every time we read stories in the Bible, we find out that the next generation didn't just happen. So Moses had to say to Joshua, you hang out with me, okay? Wherever I go, you go. I know you can't go all the way up the mountain. You go as far as you can, all right? You hang out with me, and then when it's time for me to leave, you take over this leadership. Paul had a series of young men and women in the ministry that came after him. Well, we adults who have had the advantages of growing up in the church and see its value now have to pass the leadership on to these boys to encourage everything to do. And we will ensure a new generation, and the statistics will get better. And we won't have to tell all those stories about who went to jail and who didn't go to jail, but we'll be able to tell the story of who's an Eagle Scout and who's on their way somewhere. I was just saying at my table, my nephew is an Eagle Scout. And I was using the past tense till Dr. Brewster corrected me. I said, he was an Eagle Scout. He said, no, you're always an Eagle Scout. I do believe Dr. Brewster is almost to the point where he could be a man slash Boy Scout. I don't know if he could. He happened to have developed a troop in Ohio where his senator, at that time it was Senator DeWine, said, every boy who makes Eagle Scout in my area, that was the whole state of Ohio at that time because he was one of the senators, I will make certain that he gets an appointment to one of the military academies. Turned out that my nephew did not choose to go to one of the military academies. But the very thought, then I just learned today that Secretary Gates is an Eagle Scout. Not was, but is an Eagle Scout. And I've learned a lot about what Eagle Scouting can do. Now, my own story is not quite as exciting, but I tell you that because you got to know the downside, too. I am a perpetual tenderfoot. That's all right. I'm proud of it. I didn't get to stay in the Scouts very long, but I did go. And I did go camping twice with the Scouts. I carried so much stuff, my father thought I was going away to war. But for me, it was a valuable experience, and I'm committing myself. But AMEs, please help. We know we're going to do it. God bless you, and thank you who've worked so hard for the Scouts. Thank you so much.